Hey, today we're going to assemble Uncle Digger's cabin and we're going to do it live style. I'm going to try not to edit this at all. I'm going to run the recording. What I'm going to do is I'm going to put the model down here on the desk. I'm going to switch you to the camera on the desk. I'm going to go ahead and play a quick intro video for you so I can move my light into the right place. I'm going to transition the camera. When we come back from the intro video, we'll be on this model right here and we're going to go ahead and assemble it. We're going to see if we can do this all in one take, without cutting and without editing. We want to do it live style, but we're going to put it out as a recording with a thumbnail. We're going to see how this works. This is Brian with the Iron Horse Model Railroad. Stick around for the introduction and then we're going to get to busy and we're going to assemble this model right here.
Let's get ready to rumble! Ladies and gentlemen,
Welcome to the Iron Horse Route, home of the Denver and Rio Grand Western. This is Brian. I'm glad you're here. And if you're not already a subscriber, I want to encourage you to subscribe, because when you're a subscriber here, you get access to a lot of great model railroad video uploads. And so now that you're subscribed, we invite you to sit back, relax, and enjoy today's video upload, which is coming up right now.
Let's get ready to rumble!
All right, everybody, I think you got audio on me, and we should have a good video. Let's see here. Let me adjust my camera slightly so we can show my Christmas pajamas. All right. Let's see if this camera's going to will stop auto-adjusting for us. I might need to make an adjustment on it. Let's see if we... that. Alright, so again, this is Uncle Digger's cabin, and what we've got here is we have what we have here is some of these pieces have already come off the raft so I could paint. Got the base. It's a very simple kit. You got A, B, C, and D. You got roof pieces here with your insert notches on the back so we know where they belong. Got an LED light. I have some beams for the very front. I have the chimney for the wall and the chimney for the roof. I also have a roof frame, a door frame, and then we have the door as well. Now we have the wall pieces here. Again, this is a real simple kit. And when they come on a raft like this, you just flex the raft and pop them off. But it's great to have when you're airbrushing and stuff, because it holds them down so the airbrush doesn't blow them around. And so the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and put in some window treatment real quick. Make sure I got the background music on for you, for your listening pleasure. All right. Cut a couple of these. Should have cut some of these that are wide enough where I can put the glue dot on the outside. So what we'll do is we'll just install these window treatments, let them dry, We'll connect A to B, B to C, C to D. We'll put on the roofing. Actually, we'll do those, we'll do the doors next. Then we'll do A to B, B to C, C to D. Then we'll do the roofing. Then we'll do the ground beam. I'm on the right side. Yes, I am. There, and let's get our door on there. We'll line that up in just a sec. This kid is obviously inspired by our brother across the pond, Uncle Digger. Got some glue in the window on that one. Now let's designed to have a little space on each side and on the top, but not the bottom. And we will let that dry. Alright. The chimney piece, if I'm not mistaken, it actually connects and just cuts in. So there's not a root. There's a place cut out of the roof, I think, for it. I don't see it now. Give me a minute and we'll figure out where that goes. I don't think we can put our chimneys on yet, is my point. All right. Other adhesive for the wall pieces. I will put a bead of glue there as well. I'll count to about 30 and I'll let this up for a second, and then I will try to adhere it again in just a minute. All right, I got A and A is gonna attach to B. Figured out how to do that, but pull this out for a minute. Blooper. I do that all the time live. I guess I don't need to cut that out. Alright. I'm a little worried this might be a tad short. Been wrong before, and I could be again, but looks like I need to make pieces A and C a tad bit longer. This is the first assembly for this. Maybe not. It's come together fairly well, I think. Let me look at this reviews over here. Quarter of a millimeter longer, maybe. That made a difference. I had PC upside down. The C is very easy to read upside down. I had it flipped. It's good to know because it fits a lot better now. I knew something wasn't right. Uh-oh, I lost my door. Because I used the good glue on the door. Good glue don't stick good. I don't get it, but anyway. Alright, so we need to go ahead and get this guy in there. Oh, it almost worked. One Mississippi, two Mississippi. Alright, which side of this door is the one I need to use? many applications can we complete at once? I had to do my Uncle Vinny glue trick. With the followers. Person at the buffet who just put the utensils down and grabbed the stuff with the hands. We'll go here. It's got cutouts, so it'll fit where it's supposed to go. Both of them do. I'll start with this side here. This is side A. Fits in there pretty good. See, to create a little Eve piece. Should be easy to do. Just like I do the inserts. Could probably put it on the inside too, and that way you wouldn't even see it. Chimney like a glove. And then this guy. Come in here. I didn't put an indention on the roof, which I need to do too. So I think I'm gonna make roof inserts. And I'm gonna put a indention on the roof for the chimney. I'm gonna make piece A and C. I think a quarter of a millimeter longer. That's this one and this one. I didn't do a good job of getting this piece square, and that's making this side not as square as I'd like it to be. It's not bad off at all, to be honest. Just I'm being a little picky right now. So I'm getting ready to put this over there in a little cabin alley I got. Got an Uncle Mark's cabin and an Uncle John's cabin over there beside one another. We're gonna put Uncle Digger's in. And then we're gonna do Uncle Dave's. Alright. This is a cool little cabin, I think. My attempt to make y'all not have to wait too long. I rushed it. And pushed down too hard and moved my walls. Thank you. I'll go up to the other camera in just a sec. It's in the palm of your hand. I'm gonna put an Eve here with an insert on the inside so there's no gap. I'm extending wall A and C by 0.25 millimeter. I'm gonna put an indention on the roof for the chimney. And all that I lack now are these little beams. And I need this roof to be dry for me to do the beams. Or at least close. Gentle. Alright, there we go. We have some beams. And what I'm going to do is bring you over to the other view. I'll show it to you up close under some better light. Hope I will. Stand by. Moving now. Here. Alright. A little bit too high. Alright. Let's try it this way. Here we have Uncle Digger's cabin in the end scale. There we go. A little bit better. All right. Ground beams up front, front doors, windows. Got a chimney on the side, window on this side. Couple windows. Back, nothing special. Very simple cabin, simple kit. That's how you put it together. Hope you enjoyed watching. If you're not already a subscriber, please subscribe, click the bell icon, and share this with your other modeling friends. Thanks, guys. Appreciate you. Don't forget to leave me a comment below. Smash the thumbs up, please.